the clique problem. Okay, so you have given a graph, okay, and you are asking whether the graph contains a clique of size k. Okay, now what is a clique? A clique C in an undirected graph GV is a subset of vertices. Okay, that is C is a subset of vertices such that every two distinct vertices are adjacent. Okay, for example, consider this graph. I'll say this graph has a clique of size 3. Okay, because you consider these three vertices. Okay, these three vertices are adjacent to each other. That is, you can go from A, you can go to B as well as C. C is adjacent to A as well as B. Okay, and B is adjacent to A as well as C. Okay, so this is a complete subgraph. Okay, so we can say a complete subgraph of a graph is a clique. Okay, so the clique problem is that you have given a graph and you are asking the question whether the graph is having a clique of size k. Okay, so a naive algorithm for determining whether the graph is having a clique of size k is you list all the subset of V of size k and check whether each of them form a clique. Okay, and this will take a non-polynomial time. Okay, so we cannot complete this checking in polynomial time. So the clique problem is not a P problem. Okay, so clique problem is a NP complete problem. Okay, so we have to prove clique problem is a NP complete problem. Okay, for that first we will prove a clique problem is a NP problem. Okay, so NP problems are problems that are verifiable in polynomial time. Okay, so we can verify whether the graph, if you are given a set of vertices V dash, which is a subset of vertices of the given graph, okay, then we can check whether V dash is a clique in polynomial time. Okay, by checking whether each pair UV that belongs to V dash is belong to the edges of the graph. Okay, if you are given a subset of vertices, you can check whether the vertices form a clique or not in polynomial time. So we can verify it. So this clique problem is an NP problem. Okay. Now we have to prove that the clique problem is a NP hard problem. Okay. So in order to prove that the clique problem is a NP hard problem, we have to reduce a non-NP hard problem to the clique problem. Okay, so the non-NP hard problem here I am taking is 3CNF SAT problem that we have discussed in the previous lecture. Okay, and we will reduce this CNF SAT problem to clique problem. Okay, you can take other problems as well, like a SAT problem or a circuit satisfiability problem, and reduce it into clique problem. There is no issue, but here I am reducing the 3CNF SAT problem to clique problem. Okay, so for that, I am using a 3CNF equation, Boolean equation, containing three variables, okay, and three clauses are there, each clauses containing all these three literals. Okay, now let us reduce the 3CNF SAT problem to clique problem. Okay, so for that, you may be wondering how I will transfer a satisfiability or Boolean equation to a graph. Okay, so here I will show you how to convert a Boolean equation to a graph, and then we will find out whether the graph is having a clique or not. Okay, so we have three clauses are there, okay, and each clause having three literals. Okay, so we will represent each vertex, each literal in every clause will be represented as a vertex here. Okay, so here the first clause contains three literals x1, so x1 I represent here, then negation x2 and negation x3. Okay, the second clause contains negation x1, then x2 and x3, and the third clause contains x1, x2 and x3. Okay, so these three clauses I represented here as a vertex. Okay, now from each vertex in one clause, I will draw an edge to the other vertices. Okay, I will draw an edge to vertices in the other clause. Okay, but I will not draw a vertices from a vertex to its negation. That is, I will not draw an edge from x1 to negation x1. Okay, but I will draw an edge from x1 to x2, x3, as well as x1, x2, and x3. Okay, so from x1, I will add and draw an edge from x1 to x2. Okay, then from x1 to x3. This is the second clause. Okay, then in third clause, x1 to x2, x3 as well as x1. Okay, only this one I am not drawing. From literal to its negation, I will not draw. Also to the literals in the same clauses, I will not draw a line or edge. Okay, now from negation x2, I can draw to negation x1. There is no issue. I cannot draw an edge to x2, negation x2 to x2. But I will draw an edge from negation x2 to x3. Same way here, x3 and x1 to x2 we will not draw. Okay, now we will add an edge from negation x3 to negation x1, x2, but to x3 we will not add because these are negations. Okay, here also x2 and x1 I will add. Okay, so I created edges for all the literals in the first clause. Okay, now we have so many pending literals are in the second clause. Okay, so from negation x1 I have already drawn to first clause. Now from to second clause, this x2 I will draw. Okay, then to x3, and for x2 to x1, x2 and x3 I can draw. There is no issue. From x3 to also x1, x2 and x3 I will draw. Okay, and now everything is complete. This is a complete graph, not a complete graph, sorry. Now I have drawn enough edges to connect all the literals in every clause. Okay, so this is how I will convert a 3CNF SAT or a satisfiability equation to a graph. Okay, now I converted the equation to a graph. Okay, now I have to check whether the graph is having a clique. Okay, so we have three literals here. Okay, so by looking at the graph, you can say the graph has, definitely the graph will have a clique of size 3. Okay, so if you notice, suppose x1, x2, x3, if I set x1 is equal to 1 and x2 is equal to 1 and x3 is equal to 0, this equation is satisfiable. The output of this equation will be 1 if I set x1 is equal to 1, x2 is equal to 1 and x3, because here x1, this clause will be true, this literal will be true, here this literal will become true, and here this literal will become true. Okay, so these three literals are making the equation true. Okay, so same way I can find a clique of size 3 here. Okay, that is, from x1 of first literal is true and x2 of second literal is true. Okay, so I will draw a line from x1 to x2. Okay, now x2 of second literal is true and x2 of third clause is true. Okay, so I will draw a line from x2 of second clause to x2 of third clause. Okay, now you can see there is an edge here, already there is an edge here. You can draw it back and you can say there is a clique of size 3 is here. Okay, so we have converted this satisfiability problem to clique problem. Okay, that is, satisfiability is reducible to clique. Satisfiability is a known hard problem. So clique will be also a known hard problem. That is, clique will be also a NP hard problem. And we have already proved that clique is a NP problem, since clique is both NP hard and NP, we can say that the clique problem is a NP complete problem.